California Central High School. You're about to see a production of Your Good Man, Charlie Brown, starring me, the main character, Lucy Von Pelt. Now, just a few quick things before we begin. If you look to your back and your right, you'll see these doors with this cute little exit sign on top. Those are what we call emergency exits. So in case of an emergency, a real emergency, go out those and you might survive. Now then, you know those things in your hand, you know, in your bag maybe? Yeah, your phones? Turn them off. We know we're beautiful, but please, no photos or videos. This is for your eyes, not your phones. Now then, enjoy the show!
You have anything to worry. Science has shown that a person's character isn't really established 5 years old.
But I am five. I'm more than five.
Oh. Well, that's the way it goes.
The only thing wrong with my big brother, Charlie Brown, is his lack of confidence, his inferiority, and his lack of confidence. His clumsiness, his inferiority, and his lack of confidence. His stupidity, his clumsiness, his inferiority, and his lack of confidence.
Did you know that Charlie Brown has never pitched a winning baseball game? Never has been able to keep a kite in the air? Never won a game of checkers? And never successfully punted a football? Sometimes I marvel at his consistency.
I think Charlie Brown has nice hands.
It truly is a dog's life, you know, filled with many, many challenges. You track the excitement when that round-headed kid comes home after school.
Now, Linus, I want you to take a good look at Charlie Brown's face. Would you please hold still a minute, Charlie Brown? I want Linus to study your face. Now this is what you call a failure face. Notice how it has failure written all over it. Study it carefully. You rarely see such a good example. Notice the deep lines, the dull, vacant look in the eyes. Yes, I would say this is the finest example of a failure face that you're liable to see for a long while.
Some days I like to wake up early to watch the sunrise, and I get a very positive feeling about things. Like this morning, for instance. The sky's so clear and the sun's so bright. How can anything go wrong on a day like this? I'm late!
You're a good man, Charlie Brown. You're the kind of reminder we need. You have humility, nobility, and a sense of honor that is very rare indeed. You're a good man, Charlie Brown. And we know you will go very far. Yes, it's hard to believe, almost frightening to conceive. What a good man you are.
You are kind.
You are kind to all the animals and every little bird. With a heart of gold, you believe what you're told.
Every single solitary word.
You bravely face adversity. You're cheerful through the day. You're thoughtful, brave, and courteous.
And you also have some faults, but for the moment, let's just
you're a good man, Charlie Brown. You're a prince, and a prince could be king. With a heart such as yours, you can open any doors. You can go out and do anything. You could be King Charlie Brown. You could be king.
Everybody says to me,
you're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Every voice in harmony,
you're a good man, Charlie Brown.
All I need is one more try. Gotta get that kite to fly. And I'm not the kind of guy who gives up easily. Wonder why they stop and say,
you're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Never liked me anyway.
You're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Trying not to rock the boat, not to make a scene. A good man, but I confess, I don't know what they mean. I wanna ride like I should and do everything right. But I lie awake at night,
never sleep,
with questions in my ear,
loud and deep.
I wanna join the dance,
take the leap,
but the answer isn't clear. Then I hear,
Charlie Brown, Charlie Brown,
you're a good man,
you're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Interested people. I must admit, however, I don't know much about it. I wasn't here when it happened.
I think lunchtime is among one of the worst times of day for me. Always having to sit here alone. Of course, mornings sometimes aren't so pleasant either. Waking up and wondering if anyone would really miss me if I never got out of bed. Then there's the night, too, where I lie awake thinking of all the stupid things I did during the day. And all those hours in between when I do all those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is among one of the worst times of day for me. Well, I guess I better see what I got. Peanut butter. You know, some psychiatrists say people who eat peanut butter sandwiches are lonely. I guess they're right. And when you're really lonely, the peanut butter sticks to the roof of your mouth. Boy, the PTA sure did a great job at painting these benches. There's that cute little red-headed girl eating her lunch over there. I wonder what she'd do if I went over and asked if I could sit and have lunch with her. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's hard on a face when it gets laughed in. There's an empty spot next to her on the bench. Well, there's no reason why I couldn't just go over and sit there. All I have to do is stand up. Standing up! I'm sitting down. I'm a coward. I'm so much of a coward, she wouldn't even think of looking at me. She hardly ever does look at me. In fact, I can't remember her ever looking at me. Why shouldn't she look at me? Is there any reason in the world why she shouldn't look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small, she can't spare one little moment? She's looking at me. She's looking at me!
No, Sally, you're thinking of that other dress, the one I wore to Lucinda's party. The one I'm talking about was a very light blue and had a pattern embroidered around the waist.
I don't remember.
Yes, well, it came out like this, with a sash, like this. Oh, and puffy sleeves, like this.
Oh, yes, I remember.
Yes, well, that's the dress I was wearing last week when I met Farida.
Lunchtime is among one of the worst times of day for me. If that cute little redheaded girl is looking at me with this stupid bag on my head, she'll think I'm the biggest fool alive. Maybe I could take it off quickly and she never would have noticed it. On the other hand, I can't tell if she's looking or not until I take it off. Then again, if I never take it off, I'll never have to know if she was looking or not. On the other hand, it's getting really hot in here. She's not looking at me. I wonder why she never looks at me. Oh well. One more lunch hour over with. Only 2,863 more to go. All I need is one more try. Gotta get that kite to fly. And I'm not the kind of guy who gives up easily.
With a musician.
happiness is a fleeting thing, Sally, but I believe that a man can really come close to it by directing his life towards a single goal he believes in. And I believe that a man's personal search for happiness isn't really a selfish thing either, because by achieving happiness himself, he can help others to find it. Does that make sense?
We had spaghetti in our house 3 times this week.
You know, a princess sort of thing. With a nice gown and white slippers. Oh, and a big ballroom! But I guess that's a little silly, isn't it, Charlie Brown?
No, not at all. I mean, I guess we all have our own little daydreams or ambitions or whatever you want to call them. In fact, there's one I myself have had for a few years. But I've never told anyone.
What? Charlie Brown, you can tell me!
No, I don't think I should. It's not the sort of thing you should tell.
Oh, come on. I wouldn't give it away. Come on. Please?
Well, I've always wanted to be called Flash. I hate the name Charlie. I'd like to be real athletic and have everyone call me Flash. I'd like to be so great at everything that all around school I'd be known as Flash and...
Hey, Frida, listen to this!
What's the matter, Sally?
I was jumping rope and everything was all right. And all of a sudden, it just seemed so futile.
Beethoven used to be fond of taking long walks in the country. He was always inspired by the beautiful sounds of the country.
You blockhead! Come back here with that bowl!
Beethoven had it nice.
I think I'm losing my flavor.
Oh, Snoopy, you're so adorable.
All right, Snoopy, back in your doghouse. I'll be out later with your supper.
I think Snoopy's such a wonderful dog.
Me too. He's just about the best there is.
Like me. Isn't it? Pleasant day, pretty sky, life goes on, here I lie, not bad at all. Cozy home, board and bed, sturdy roof beneath my head, not bad at all. Friends always near me, pretty bones scratch my ear, little birds come to cheer me, every day sitting here on my stomach, the sharp little claws, they're usually cold and a little bit sharp, but sometimes there's so many that I can hardly stand it. You know, I never realized how far it was to the ground from here. Ooh, mama.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. Where was I? Oh, that's right. The pretty sky. Not bad. Not bad at all. Cozy home. Board and bed. Dirty room. Beneath my head. Not bad. Not bad at all. Not bad. Not bad at all. You know, I wonder if it'll snow tonight. Oh.
I think I'll march right up to that little red-headed girl and introduce myself. I think I'll tell her to sit next to me, and I think I'll tell her how much I've always admired her. I think I'll flap my arms and fly to the moon.
Yesterday I was a dog. Today I was a dog. Tomorrow, I'll probably still be a dog. There's just a little hope of advancement.
Today is April Fool's Day,
Charlie Brown.
I think I'll play a little trick. I think I'll try a little trick. You do understand what I'm saying, don't you? That today is April Fool's Day? You're sure? I want to be certain you understand. All right. Oh, Charlie Brown, look over there. It's that cute little red-headed girl, and she wants to give you a hug and a kiss.
Really? Wow, this is fantastic.
April Fool. It's like shooting fish in a barrel.
Zoomy! Wake up! You see the stick? I, the human, will throw the stick, and you, the dog, will retrieve it.
I, the dog, cannot be less interested.
I got it!
Back my blanket!
No! I've got it, and I'm going to keep it. This is just the first step towards breaking that disgusting habit of yours.
Really, you haven't read the latest scientific reports. A blanket is just as important to a child as a hobby is to an adult. Many a man spend their days restoring antique automobiles, or building model trains, or collecting old telephones, or even reading about the Civil War. This is called playing with the past.
Really?
Certainly. And this is good, for it helps these men cope with their everyday problems. Now, I believe that it is going to be absolutely necessary that I get my blanket back, so I'm just going to give it a good yank. It's surprising how much you can accomplish with a little smooth talk and some fast action. Them without a blanket is like eating a cone without ice cream. Mm-hmm. my blanket and me. What do you mean? It's a cozy sanctuary from necessary, cause I'm just as self-reliant as before. As a simple demonstration of my independent station, I will go and leave my blanket on the floor. Yes, I'll walk away and leave it, though I'm sure you won't believe it. I'll just walk away and leave it on the floor. La 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 la. So walk away and leave it on the...
Linus!
I thought I could do it. I actually thought I could do it. Try to outgrow it, but meanwhile, it's my blanket. So that you consume the throne after the death. I can't think of any possible way that you could ever become a queen. I'm sorry, Lucy, but it's true.
And in the summertime, I will go to my summer palace, and I will wear my crown and swimming and everything. And when I go out in the streets, all the people will wave and cheer, and I will shout at them. You mean I can't be queen?
It's true.
No, there's got to be a loophole. There's always a loophole with these sorts of things. No one should be kept from being queen if she wants to be one. It's undemocratic!
Good grief.
It's usually just a matter of knowing the right people. Yes, I've had a few well-placed correspondences, and I will be queen in no time.
Oh, think I'll watch television.
I know what I'll do. If I can't be queen, then I will be very rich. I will work and work until I am very rich. And then I will buy myself a queendom.
Good grief.
Yes, I will buy myself a queendom and kick out the old queen and take over the whole operation myself. I will become head queen. Okay, switch channels.
Are you kidding? I'm not just one of your royal subjects. What makes
you think you can come
right in here and take over?
These five fingers, individually, they are nothing. But when I curl them together into a single unit, they become a fighting force terrible to behold!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Supper time!
Not yet.
Supper time!
Not yet!
A C! A C! I got a C on my coat hanger sculpture! How could anyone get a C on a coat hanger sculpture? May I ask a question? Was I judged on the piece of the sculpture itself? If so, is it not true that time alone can judge a work of art? Or was I judged on my talent? If so, is it right that I be judged on a part of my life over which I have no control? Perhaps I was judged on what I had learned about this project. If so, were not you, my teacher, also being judged on your ability to transmit your knowledge to me? Are you willing to share my C? Perhaps I was being judged on the quality of the coat hanger itself, out of which my creation was made. Now, is this not also unfair? Am I to be judged on the quality of coat hangers that are given out by the dry cleaning establishment that returns our garments? Is that not the responsibility of my parents? Should they not share my sea? Thank you, Miss Oathmart. The squeaky wheel gets the grease.
A little more rope, a little more wind, a little more hope. Gotta get this stupid kite to fly. Gotta make sure it doesn't snag, doesn't droop, doesn't drag. Gotta watch out for every little. Less speed, a little more tack, less rise, a little more slack. Gotta keep, it's about me now. Make sure it doesn't get the best of me till I get it in the air somehow. Millions of little kids do it every day. Make a kite and poof, it's in the sky. Leave it to me to have the one purple kite who likes to see a little kid cry. Let's talk a little more will, less more skill. Gotta face this fell eye to eye. Now that I've seen you chasing moles, climbing trees, digging holes, catching your string on everything passing by, why not fly? Isn't on the ground, it isn't in a tree, it's in the air. Look at that, it's caught a breeze now, it's past the trees now, with room to I'm not such a clumsy guy. If I really try, I can really fly.
How are you today, Sally?
I'm mad. I'm mad at the whole world.
Are you mad at everybody in the whole world?
I'm mad at everybody.
Are you mad at all the animals? And the bird and the fish? All the trees and all the flowers?
I'm mad at them too. I'm mad at everything.
Are you mad at the sky? Are you mad at the stars? Are you mad at the ground? Are you mad at the rocks? Are you mad at cars and TVs and buildings and circuses and roller skates and bracelets?
You didn't mention jump ropes.
Are you mad at jump ropes?
I'm especially mad at jump ropes!
Here, this is for you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. No, that doesn't sound right. Here, Lucy, this is for you. Happy Valentine's Day. You can do it if you just don't get nervous. This is for you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. Stay calm. You can do it. This is for you, Lucy. Merry Christmas. Oh. I'd give anything if that little red-headed girl sent me a valentine. Maybe she did send me one. Maybe she sent me a valentine, and it's in our mailbox right now. I'm afraid to look. If I look and there's nothing there, I'll be crushed. On the other hand, oh, I've got to look. Hello? Hello? Nothing echoes like an empty mailbox.
I've been thinking about why you didn't get any valentines, big brother. I think I figured it out. You didn't get any valentines because no one sent you any.
Look at them all laughing and enjoying themselves with their valentines. I sent a valentine to everyone I know this Valentine's Day. And did I get one back? No, not one. I did not get a single valentine. Everyone gets valentines but me. Nobody likes me. I get about as many valentines as a dog. I'm gonna be sick. Excuse me. Oh, Lucy, I'm so depressed. Everything's going wrong, and I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, I'm very sorry to hear that, Charlie Brown. Maybe there's something I could do to help. I think what you need most of all is to come right out and admit all the things that are wrong with you.
Do you really think that'll help, Lucy?
Why, certainly.
All right, I'll give it a try. I'm not very handsome or clever or lucid. I've always been stupid at spelling and numbers. I've never been much playing football or baseball or stickball or checkers or marbles or ping pong. I'm usually awful at parties and dances. I stand like a stick, or I cough, or I laugh, or I don't bring a present, or I spill the ice cream, or I get so depressed that I stand in ice cream. Oh, how could there possibly be one small person as thoroughly, totally, utterly, blah, as me?
Well, that's okay for a starter.
A starter?
Why, certainly. You don't think that mentioning these few superficial things is going to do you any good, do you? Why, Charlie Brown, you really have to delve. You're stupid, self-centered, and moody.
I'm moody.
You're terribly dull to be with.
Yes, I am. And nobody likes me, not Frida, or Shermie, or Linus, or Schroeder.
Or Lucy. Or Snoopy.
Now, wait a minute. Snoopy likes me.
He only pretends to like you because you feed him. That doesn't count.
Or Snoopy. Oh, why was I born just to be person as thoroughly, totally, utterly...
Wait! You're not very much of a person.
That's certain.
And yet there is reason for hope.
There's hope?
For although you are no good at music like Schroeder, or happy like Snoopy, or lovely like me, you have the distinction to be no one else but the singular, remarkable, unique Charlie Brown.
I mean... something? I'm beginning to feel a lot better already. You're a true friend, Lucy. A true friend.
That'll be 5 cents, please.
If I wanted fudge marble, chocolate, rocky road, vanilla, or butter pecan. I finally decided to try fudge marble. Then I had to choose between a plain cone and a sugar cone. I obviously picked the sugar cone. So what happened? I walked out the door and dropped the whole thing on the sidewalk. Don't tell me my life isn't a Shakespearean tragedy. You see what I mean? Jump ropes!
Today's my grandfather's birthday!
How old is he?
63. It's hard to believe that he once was a human.
Why is it that I always have my supper in the red dish? And my drinking water in the blue dish? One of these days, I'm gonna put my supper in the blue dish and my drinking water in the red dish. Life is just too short not to live it up a little.
Schroeder, do musicians make a lot of money?
Money? Who cares about money? This is art, you blockhead! Playing great music isn't art, and this is great music I'm playing! Do you hear me? And art! 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 Art!
You fascinate me! What?
Principal and hand him the news. We got a holiday that he can't refuse. A day of harmony, a day of music. Beethoven's birthday. A rebel racial mission.
It's a good day.
The hope of each musician. No more am I the only guy to stand up and say, hooray,
Beethoven day.
Yes, as Ludwig van Beethoven, composer, born 1770, died 1827. The others have 3 sons.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. Schroeder, I just want to let you know that I'm on your side, publicity-wise, since this is such a big occasion.
I thank you for your support, Lucy, but I just don't want to see Beethoven's birthday commercialized.
Commercialized?
Yes, the next thing you know, they'll be wearing Beethoven t-shirts.
Beethoven Day?
If you're wondering how do we start, just blow the music till you know it by heart. We're gonna celebrate. We'll throw a party. Beethoven's birthday.
Beethoven Day.
A symphonic jumbo.
Beethoven Day.
A polyphonic jumbo. We'll ride up every boy and girl to stand up and say,
hooray, Beethoven, hooray.
Beethoven Day.
Beethoven Day.
We'll have a bake sale.
Wait, that's too commercial! Let's imagine it, that glorious hour. Filled with emotion, yet inspired with power. As we all honor the man we adore. Our favorite place, the newest space on Mount Rushmore.
Mount Rushmore. Beethoven Day.
A moment of reflection.
Beethoven Day.
A classical injection. So facing this direction, we begin it today. A musical collection, everybody can play. So right up that boy and girls will stand up and say, hooray, Beethoven.
Snoopy, it's a magnificent day for chasing rabbits. The air is clear, the sun is shining, the fields and woodlands are open and inviting.
If it's such a magnificent day, why spoil it for the rabbits?
Come on, Snoopy. Where's your spirit of adventure? Where's that old thrill of the chase? What kind of dog are you anyway?
I am a sleeping dog. You take it from there.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, wasting a perfect day like this. The scent is fresh, the trail is clear. Let's get out there and track down a big old rabbit.
Well,
she's determined. If that's what she wants, she might as well get her money's worth.
Attaboy, Snoopy. We ought to see lots of game today.
Sometimes when you're depressed, all you want to do is nothing. All you want to do is lean your head on your arm and stare off into space. This can go on for many hours. If you're unusually depressed, you may have to change arms.
Of me I gave you?
I threw it away.
With your own hands?
Of course.
He touched my picture!
Bad time for me. Maybe if I'm lucky, tomorrow will be a better day.
In some parts of the world, tomorrow's already today. And today's yesterday. If tomorrow's already today, Charlie Brown, then there's no way that tomorrow can be a better day.
You're a lot of fun to have around.
We will now have a 10-minute intermission.
suddenly, anti-aircraft fire, Archie, we used to call it, begins to burst beneath my plane. The Red Baron has spotted me. Aha!
Na 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 na, you can't hit me.
Actually, tough flying aces never say
nya 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 nya.
I was just trapped. This fog. It's bad enough to have to fight the Red Baron, and then to fly in weather like this? Right, Red Baron. Are you? The sun has broken through. I can see the woods and Monta set down below. Oh, you look nice this time of year. And what's that? Oh, wow. Wowee. It's a Fokker triplane. I've got you this time, Red Baron. Oh no, he's diving out of the sun. I've got to run. Come on, Papa Camel. Let's go. Oh, go. Whoa! We gotta let's destroy him! Oh no! He's riddling my plane with bullets! Ah! 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 Keep banning me. Here's the World War I flying ace back at him. He's exhausted. Sleep. But one thought continues to burn in his mind. Someday! Someday I'll see you, Red Baron!
Oh yeah, that's what you think. Oh yeah, that's what you think. Oh yeah, that's what you think.
What?
That's my new philosophy. Oh yeah, that's what you think.
Well, why are you telling me?
What?
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it! That's a good philosophy. Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? My new philosophy. The teacher gave a D on last week's homework. She said, Miss Sally Brown, your grades are going down. I could have told her.
Your new philosophy.
My new philosophy. Miss B, I'm she. Look, C, a D, a D. Well, why are you telling me? And that's my new philosophy.
That's your new philosophy.
Why are you telling me my new philosophy?
Well, that's great and all, Sally, but I have to go practice Chopin's Nocturne in B-flat minor.
No! I like it. No! That's a good philosophy. No! No! No!
That's your new philosophy, huh?
Yes! I mean, no! Just like a busy bee, each new philosophy can fly from tree to tree and keep me moving. When life's a busy maze on alternating days, I choose a different phrase.
Your new philosophy.
My new philosophy.
Sally, some philosophies are simple. Man does not live by bread alone. Some philosophies are clear.
Leave your message at the sound of the tone.
Some philosophies pick and choose. Deciding what goes in.
Some take a lifetime.
Mine take a minute.
But Sally, anything that only takes a minute can't be very lasting. For instance, Beethoven took over 2 years to complete his brilliant Ninth Symphony.
No!
I can't stand it!
I can't stand it! I like it!
Philosophies aren't for all people.
And that's my new philosophy!
I want this to be our biggest and best game of the season, and I want everyone out there giving it all that he's got.
Charlie Brown, I thought up some new strategy for you. What if we tell the other team that we're going to play them at a certain place? Only it isn't the real place, see? And then, when they don't show up, we'll win by default! Isn't that a good strategy? What is it with these managers and not wanting to use good strategy?
The thing we really have to remember is spirit and teamwork. I'm sure if we grit
our teeth... The other team was trash-talking us, Charlie Brown. But I got even with them, though. You know what I said? I said, you guys think you're so great? Mozart was writing symphonies before he was your age! That really shut him up.
I'll bet it did. If we grit our teeth and bear down, I'm sure we can finish
Perhaps
off...
Perhaps you shouldn't be a playing manager, Charlie Brown. Perhaps you should be a bench manager.
That's a good idea. You'd be a great bench manager, Big Brother. You could be like, bench, do this, or bench, do that. And when we get to the playing field, you could even decide where to put the bench. You could be like, let's put the bench here, or let's put the bench there.
I can't stand it.
What's the sense of our playing when we know we're going to lose? If there is even a million to one chance we might win, it would make some sense.
Yeah.
Well, there may not be a million to one chance, but I'm sure there's at least a billion to one chance.
Yeah!
Come on, give me a T!
T!
Give me an E!
E!
Give me an A!
A!
Give me an M!
M!
What you got?
T!
There is no team like the best team, which is our team right here. We will show you we're the best team in the very little league this year. And in no time, we'll be big time. With the big league baseball stars. For all we have to do is win just one more game, and the championship is ours.
Dear pen pal, you'll never guess what happened today at the baseball game. It's hard to believe what happened today at the baseball game. I was the manager, Schroeder was catcher, and all of the team was the same as always, but somehow or other, disaster struck at the baseball game. Huddle up! What I mean? Three balls, two strikes, the bases were loaded with two men out. I pitched my curve, but somehow he hit it a good, strong clout. Lucia hollered, "It's coming right at you." She caught it as easy as pie and dropped it. I don't think it's good for a team's morale to see their manager cry. Snoopy held out by biting a runner and catching the ball with his teeth. Linus caught flies from a third-story window by holding his blanket beneath. Yes, we had to. No one can argue with that. And one run would win us the game as I came up to bat.
type, Charlie Brown. We're all behind you, sort of. I mean, this kid can't pitch, Charlie Brown. He pitches like my grandmother. Now, all you have to do is bear down, just bear down. And when you get to first, watch me for my signals. Got it, Flash?
All we have to do is win just one more game.
And the championship is ours.
Moving Bron with two out and me with one strike. This cute little red-headed girl I know. Firmly I vowed I would win it for her as I shouldered my bat and I swung. Dear Pen Pal, where you live is really quite far. Could you please send directions on how I can get where you are?
Your friend,
Charlie Brown.
Just like this one, and I toss it to all the women in the audience and see who could be the new bride.
Lucy! I'm sorry I have to say it right to your face, but it's true. You're a very... You're a very crabby person. And your crabbiness has probably become so natural to you that you're not even aware when you're being crabby. But it's true just the same. You're a very... crabby person. And you're crabby just about everyone you meet. Now, I hope you don't mind me saying this, Lucy, but I hope you take it in the spirit that it's meant. I think that we should all be open to any opportunity to learn more about ourselves. I think Socrates was right when he said, the first rule for anyone in life is to know thyself. Yes. Well, I think I've said about enough. I hope I haven't offended you or anything.
Well, what Socrates got to do with it anyways? Who was she anyways? Tell me that. Did she ever get to be queen, huh? Did she ever get to be queen? Who was Socrates anyway? Know thyself.
All right, Snoopy. You want to come out and help me get my arm back in shape? Watch this one. It's a new fastball.
Charlie Brown, I was wondering if I could ask you a few quick questions.
Certainly, Lucy.
Yes, well, I'm conducting a survey, and I was wondering, on a scale from 0 to 100, with 50 as average, 75 as above average, and 90 as exceptional, where would you rate me in regards to, crabbiness?
Well, Lucy,
Your ballots need not be signed, and all answers will be held in strictest confidence.
Well, still, Lucy, that's a very hard question to answer.
You may have a few moments to think it over if you'd like. Or we can come back to it later.
I'd like to come back to it if you don't mind.
All right. Now, the next question deals with certain character traits you may have noticed. In regards to my personality, would you say that I am A, forceful, B, pleasing, or C, objectionable? Would that be A, B, or C, Charlie Brown? What would your answer be to that, Charlie Brown?
Well, Lucy, I guess I'd have to say forceful, but...
A. Forceful. Put a check mark by the letter A, then. Now then, would you rate my ability to get along with others as poor? The other way. Fair, good, or excellent?
I think that depends a lot on what you mean by getting along with other people.
Oh, you know, make friends, sparkle in a crowd, that sort of thing.
Do you have a spot for abstention?
Certainly. I'll just put a check by none of the above. Now then, the next question deals with physical appearance. In regarding mine, would you say that I am stunning, mysterious, or over there, you bird brain! Intoxicating.
Gee, Lucy, I don't know. You look just fine to me.
Stunning! All right, Charlie Brown. I think it's about time we get back to that first question. On a scale from 0 to 100 to 50, is that what we got?
Remember the question, Lucy.
Then what is your answer?
51?
51! 51 is your crabbiness rating for me. Yes, well, that about does it, I guess. Thank you very much. Your cooperation has been greatly appreciated.
Certainly, Lucy. By all means. Come on, Snoopy.
Charlie Brown! One more question. Would you answer yes or no to the following? Is Lucy Von Pelt, that's me, by the way, the type of person you would like to have as the head of your school, club, or organization?
Yes, by all means, Lucy. Ha ha ha.
Yes, well, that about does it. Thank you very much. Well, who asked you? 51A? Schroeder was right. I can already feel myself being filled with the glow of self-awareness. Sally, I'm conducting a survey, and I was wondering...
110, C, 4, none of the above. No! And what are you going to do about that dent you made in my bicycle?
It's amazing how fast word of these surveys spreads. Linus! I was wondering if I could ask you a few quick questions.
Sure. Go ahead.
Yes, well, I'm conducting a survey! And I was wondering, on a scale from 0 to 100, with 50 as average, 75 as above average, and 90 as exceptional, where would you rate me in regards to crabbiness?
Well, I'm a big sister.
That's not the question, Linus.
No, that's the answer, Lucy.
Answer the question, Linus.
Look, Lucy, I know very well that if I give you any sort of an honest answer to that question, you're going to slug me.
Linus, a survey that is based upon false answers is like a house that is built on a foundation of sand. Would I be wasting my time conducting this survey if I didn't expect complete candor in all responses? I promise. I won't slug you. Now, what is your crabbiness rating?
95?
It is a woman's prerogative to change her mind. Now then, I add these two columns together, and that gives me my answer. There, let's see what we've got. It's true. I'm a crabby person. I'm a very crabby person, and everybody knows it. I've been spreading crabbiness everywhere I go. I'm a super crab. It's a wonder anyone will still talk to me. It's a wonder I have friends at all, or even associates. Where did I go wrong? How could I have been so selfish? How could... Don't talk to me, Linus. I don't deserve to breathe the air I breathe.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. There's no reason why I should go on living on this planet.
Yes, there is.
Name one. Name one reason why I should go on living on this planet.
Well, for one thing, you have a little brother who loves you. Every now and then, I say the right thing.
Of course it's a surprise, but I'm pretty sure Lucy knows she can't be crabby anymore.
Anymore?
Where is everybody? I told them to be here.
You told them to be here.
If we can't rehearse, we can't sing at the assembly tomorrow.
The assembly tomorrow.
Charlie Brown.
Charlie Brown.
Linus.
Linus.
Lucy.
Lucy.
Back here with that pencil, you blockhead.
No, not until you give me back my crayons.
That's my favorite pencil, you If you don't give me back that pencil, I'll tell Sally what you said about her.
Stop that. We gotta rehearse. You're late.
What did you say about me, Linus?
He said...
Lucy, stop that!
I'm sorry, I'm late.
There's no time to be sorry.
What did he say?
He said...
Quiet! Now remember, this is a mood piece. We must paint a picture with music and words. And concentrate! All together? Now remember, andaggio con brio.
Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play.
My pencil.
Where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day.
If you don't tell me what you're saying, I'm going to
get
you. Boy, what a horrible thing! What a terrible thing to say about a person! What's an enigma? Never mind.
Where are the... What's an enigma?
What's an enigma?
Oh, play! Set out my pencil!
Where seldom is heard a discouraged.
And the skies are not cloudy all day.
I've been wondering when it was when dogs first began to be regarded as man's best friend.
Probably right after the invention of cookies.
Oh.
Oh no, my teeth are tingling again. I've just gotta bite somebody before sundown, or else I'll go stark raving mad. Yet, society frowns upon such an action. So what happens? I'm stuck with tingly teeth.
Each family has a chain of command. And do you know who's the lowest on that chain? Guess! It's the dog. The dog is the lowest. Do you understand that? I said, do you understand that?
They hate it when you stare at them like this. Point Snoopy. Go Snoopy. Go Snoopy.
Going, Linus?
Lucy's teaching me, Charlie Brown. She says that a sister's responsible for the education of her little brother. So she's teaching me.
Boy, she's intelligent.
Come along, Linus.
girls.
Is that so?
That's right. They run around all day long, tugging and tugging on each little seed until it grows up into a great tall blade of grass.
That's amazing.
Oh, good grief.
And this thing here, it's called a hydrant. They grow all over, and no one seems to know just how a little thing like that gets so much water. Do you see that bird? It's called an eagle, but since it's little, it has another name, a sparrow. And on Christmas and Thanksgiving, we eat them.
Lucy, how can you say that? I'm sorry, but I can't stand idly by.
And way up there, the little stars and planets make the rain fall in showers. When it's cold and winter is upon us, the snow comes up, just like the flowers.
Now I know that's wrong. Snow doesn't come up, it goes down.
After it comes up, Charlie Brown, the wind blows it around so it looks like it's coming down. But actually, it comes up like the grass. Snow comes up, Charlie Brown, snow comes up.
I can't stand it.
Now, Lucy, why is Charlie Brown banging his head up against that tree?
To loosen the bark to make the tree grow faster. Ugh. Come along, Linus. Clouds can make the wind blow. Bugs can make the grass grow. So there you go. These are little known facts that now you know.
Stomach clock just went off. It's supper time, and Charlie Brown has forgotten to feed me. Here I lie, a withering, hollow shell of a dog, and there sits my supper dish, empty. But that's all right. He'll remember. When old furry friend comes to greet him after school, then he'll remember, and he'll rush out here to the doghouse, but it'll be too late. There'll be nothing left but the dried carcass of his former friend. He used to love to laugh and run and play so happily with them. Nothing left but the bleached puppy bones.
Hey, Snoopy! Are you asleep or something? I've been standing here a whole minute with your supper.
Supper time! Supper time! Behold, a ring full of meat and meal, which has brought forth to ease our hunger. Behold, a flowing flagon moist and sweet, which has been sent to slake our thirst.
Oh my, no need for a big production. Just get off that doghouse and eat.
Do 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 da do do, do 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 da do do. It's supper time, yeah, it's supper time. Oh, it's supper time, very best time of day. It's supper time, yeah, it's supper time. And when supper time comes, can supper be far away? Bring on the soup dish, bring on the cup, bring on the bacon and fill me up, cause it's supper, 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 supper time. Bada ba doo ba, zaba da ba da ba da, supper time. Bring on the bones, bring on the barrel and roll me home, cause it's supper, 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 super pepper upper, supper, super duper supper time. Winter time, nice with the ice and snow,
Summertime's nice with a place to go. A bedtime, overtime, halftime suit, but they just can't hold a candle to my supper time. Oh, yeah! Hi, a homeless nurse. How are ya? Bring on the hamburgers. Bring on the bun. Poppy's little pupper loves everyone. Is it supper? Supper, 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 supper. Super pepper upper. Supper. Super duper supper time. Oh, yeah.
Supper time.
Oh, yeah. Give me food, give me water, give me something to do.
Now cut
that out.
Why can't you eat your meal quietly and calmly like any other normal dog?
So what's wrong with making mealtime a joyous occasion? Supper, 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 supper.
Maybe even a satellite.
It could be a satellite. I wonder.
Well, we'll never find out by just standing here.
Where are you going?
I'm going over here to get a closer look. I like to sit up here after some time and listen to the sounds of the night. But something seems to be missing. In my opinion, that's exactly what it needed.
That little red-headed girl dropped her pencil. It had teeth marks all over it. She bites her pencil. She's human. It hasn't been such a bad day after all. Happiness is finding a pencil.
Pizza with sausage.
Telling the time.
Happiness is learning to whistle.
Tying your shoe for the very first time.
Climbing a tree.
Happiness is five different crayons.
Catching a firefly, setting him free.
Happiness is being alone every now and then.
And happiness is coming home again.
Happiness is having a sister,
sharing a sandwich,
getting along. Happiness is singing together when day is through. And happiness is those who sing with you.
Daytime and nighttime too.
anything at all. That's love by you.
You're a good man, Charlie Brown.
Teacher here. I do it all. And I just want to say thank you for coming out tonight. This cast has been amazing to work with. They've cranked out this show in 2.5 months, which is pretty much unheard of. So I'm very, very impressed by you guys, and I love you guys. And I just want to say thank you to all the parents here who have supported these kids. We would not be here without you guys. And I'd also like to give a special shout out to Miss Julie Self up there today. She's been my partner in crime for this show, and she's helped with all the lights and sound, and also her husband. Wow. Her son, Justin, has been. I'd also like to thank our broadcasting class and Mr. Holt. They are filming here today, so thank you guys. And one final shout out to our admins here and all the teachers here who have helped with everything that we've done this week. And thank you guys so much for coming out and supporting the arts here at CHS. We love you guys. Thank you. Have a great night.
Wait.
Okay, well, that's something that a lot of you guys may not know.
Okay.
Today is Miss Vernon's birthday.
Happy birthday together, because she is the most amazing director.
Thank
and she
you.
Has done so much for us. So
thank
we
you.
Just want to make sure that this is a special day for
aww,
you.
Aw, so sweet.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
I love you guys.
Happy birthday to
you. Have you done?
Happy birthday to you.
Oh my audience. Okay. Sorry, guys.
Like,
I'll try
just
to
say thank you for spending your birthday with us.
Yeah. Aww.
Yeah.
We're still working.
You guys are so
much,
sweet.
You.
Sneakers.
You
want me to read?
Your favorite candy now.
Y'all were so sneaky. Asked me what my favorite candy was.
I did.
Oh, you guys are awesome. Ooh, I'm going to use this for sure. Oh, thank you guys so much. You're awesome. I love it. Thank you guys. We'll be out in the lobby to say hello to everyone. Thank you so much. You guys are awesome. I love you guys.